بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله حمدا طيبا كثيرا كما أمر، والصلاة والسلام على سيد البشر صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. Honored ulama, respected brothers, sisters and beloved children, Inshallah, briefly I'll be talking today about the great gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what we all has been blessed with. That no matter someone is Muslim or non-Muslim, believer or non-believer, men or women, boys or girls, old or young, yes, everyone has been blessed with as a key and solutions to all our problem we may be having. Challenges we may be facing, anything we may be desiring in our life. Whenever in our life we feel alone, loneliness, what's happened? With some hope went to the father, mother, brothers, sisters, sons and daughters, wife and husband, family and friends, circle and community. But unfortunately, no one is ready to listen, talk and understand. Finally, we return as an hopeless, broken heart and empty hand. Thinking and thought start taking place in our mind and heart that I'm alone in this huge world. I'm alone in this huge world. Is there anyone? My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, even at that moment, relax yourself. Have a peace of a mind and contentment of the heart. And don't worry at all. When all the doors of the dunya has been closed on you, just remember, always one door will still remain open for you. That is the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the key has been given to you as a great gift of Allah in the form of dua. Yes, great gift of Allah in the form of dua. It seems so simple, but it is very, very, very noble and powerful. See what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayat 186. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي. O Prophet, whenever my slaves comes to you, some may be a kafir, some may be a mushrik, some may be a Muslim, some may be a mu'min, some may be a sinner, some may be an evildoer, as an asi and khati, asking about me, Ayn Allah, Ayn Allah, where is Allah? Respond them, fa inni qareeb, I am very, very, very near to them. Ujibu da'wat ad-da'i idha da'an. I respond the calls of every caller. Tell them they have been returned as an hopeless, broken heart and empty hand from the door of the people. But they won't be returned as an hopeless, broken heart and empty hand from the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu. Whatever problem you may be having, whatever challenges you may be facing, anything you may be desiring for your life, just call upon Allah. Allah will respond your call immediately, will show you the way out of the problem, will grant you each and everything, yes, everything, everything according to your expectation. Subhanallah. It is also so true. What we get easily in our life, we don't hold much value for it. Something that doesn't cost us anything, sometimes we don't understand the importance about it. But see what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in regards to the great gift of Allah as in dua in the book of Tirmizi, hadith number 3370. لَيْسَ شَيْءٌ أَكْرَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مِنَ الدُّعَى. O man, no gift ever has been given to any human being in general more valuable, noble and powerful in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than dua. Subhanallah. in the book of Tirmizi, hadith number 3371. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ad-du'a mukhul ibadah." Dua is a sense of ibadah, subhanAllah. MashaAllah, we all know very well, performing salah is ibadah, fasting is ibadah, giving zakah is ibadah, going for hajj and umrah is ibadah, giving charity is ibadah, being nice and kind to complete humanity is ibadah. But do we also know, dua, supplication, is not only ibadah, but indeed is an essence of ibadah. Move further and see what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the book of Bukhari, hadith number 1145, that Allah says, "Man yad'uni fa astajib lahu. Man yastaghfiruni fa aghfir lahu. Man yad'uni fa astajib lahu. Man yas'aluni fa u'tiyahu. Man yastaghfiruni fa aghfir lahu." Aw kama qala alayhi salatu wassalam. O man, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his peace and blessing, mercy and forgiveness, for all the goods of this dunya and akhirah, because Allah loved to give and forgive. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the book of Tirmizi, hadith number 3571, "Sallallahu ta'ala min fadli." O men, call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything. For everything, for anything. You're having worldly problem, call upon Allah. You're having social problem, call upon Allah. You're having financial problem, call upon Allah. You're having family problem, call upon Allah. You're having educational problem, call upon Allah. You're having job problem, call upon Allah. You're having health problem, call upon Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond your call immediately. Subhanallah. You're willing and desiring anything in your life, willing to be a scholar, doctor, professor, engineer, architecture, contractor, designer, business holder, company owner, richer, millionaire and billionaire, just call upon Allah. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ أَن يُسْأَلْ. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love to be called. Prophet Adam alayhi salatu wa salam called upon Allah when he was placed in this dunya. Prophet Nuh called upon Allah when complete world was flooded. Prophet Ibrahim called upon Allah when he was thrown into the huge fire. Prophet Yaqub called upon Allah when his beloved son was misplaced. Prophet Yusuf called upon Allah when he was thrown into the dark well. Prophet Musa called upon Allah when there was shortage of sustenance for the people of Bani Israel. Prophet Zakaria called upon Allah when he was in the need of the child. Prophet Yunus called upon Allah when he was in difficult moment of his life. Prophet Ayyub called upon Allah when he was going through very painful illness and sickness. Prophet Isa called upon Allah when he was surrounded by evil planner. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called upon Allah all his life and said in the book of Muslim, hadith number 6892, that Allah says, "Ana inda zanni abdi bi wana ma'hu idha da'ani." O men, call upon Allah for anything and everything. Don't see who you are, just see whom you're calling to. You're kafir, call upon Allah. You're mushrik, call upon Allah. You're mulhid, call upon Allah. You're fasiq, call upon Allah. You're khati, call upon Allah. You're asi, call upon Allah. You're zani, call upon Allah. You're sinner, call upon Allah. You're evil doer or planner, call upon Allah. Allah will respond your call immediately. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Or your atqiyah, sulaha, ulama, call upon Allah. Your aghniya, fuqara, or zu'afa, Call upon Allah. Allah will respond your call immediately, because Allah loves to be called and He's very happy to give and grant. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Move further and see what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. In the book of Tirmizi, hadith number 3556. Allahu yastahyi idha rafa'a ar-rajulu ilayhi yadayhi an yaruddahuma sifran khaibatayn. Whenever any slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises his hand and says, Ya Allah, before he's able to complete his sentence, the response comes immediately from Allah. Ya Abdullah, yes, O my slave, what you need? I'm ready to give you and grant you and forgive you. Subhanallah. And then person says, Rabbana zalamna anfusana. Oh Allah, I have done a zulm on myself. I went against of you. I went against of the Prophet. I went against of the Quran. I went against of the Sharia. Rabbana faghfir lana dhunubana. Oh Allah, forgive me. Oh Allah, forgive me. Allah said, I have forgive you. Then person says, Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana. Oh Allah, grants me all the goods of this dunya. Wa fil akhirati hasana. And all the goods of the akhirah. The response comes, oh my slave, you has been granted. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised the hand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahu yastahyi, Allah shy to return any of his slave. As a hopeless, broken heart, an empty hand from the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the person had made a dua and had called upon Allah. My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, hope these ayah of the Quran and the beautiful hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is more than enough to understand the value and virtue of great gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as in dua. As in dua. Dua doesn't cost us anything. Yes, anything. But it is so true. So true, we can achieve through the dua everything. Yes, everything and everything.